Welcome to Bio-Rad's Blackboard Training. This is a series of short, informal tutorials brought to you by industry experts. Today, we'll cover total error. Total error is the overall error in a single test result due to the imprecision and bias in a test system. The total error formula consists of three components: Z-score, imprecision, and bias. Let's examine each of the components in more detail. We'll start with Z-score. The Z-score is the desired probability of inclusion inside the target limits. Dr. Cullum Fraser provided the following example of probabilities and Z-scores in his text, Biological Variation, From Principles to Practice. If we desire to include 99% of the values within our target limits, then we need to use a Z-score of 2.33. This equals an inclusion probability of P less than 0.01. The second component of the equation is imprecision. Imprecision is expressed as a coefficient of variation, or CV. To calculate for CV, divide the laboratory's standard deviation by the laboratory's mean, then convert the results to a percent by multiplying by 100. I encourage you to take a look at our video for calculating CV percent if you need additional information. The last component of the total error equation is bias. This is expressed as bias percent. To calculate bias percent, subtract the consensus group mean from the laboratory's mean, and then divide by the consensus group mean. Convert the result to a percent by multiplying by 100. When we use bias in the equation to calculate for TE, we only use absolute values, so any signs, negative or positive, are dropped. Now that we understand all the components, let's practice calculating the TE for serum glucose. Let's move our formula down into the corner, just in case we need it. These are our values for Z-score, CV percent, and bias percent. We've chosen a Z-score of 1.65% because we want to include 95% of the values within our target limits. Let's begin by copying down the formula, and then by substituting in the values. We multiply the Z-score by the CV percent, then add the bias percent. The TE turns out to be 6.9%. Now let's do a little practice equation on your own. Pause the video when the values appear. This will give you a chance to grab pen, paper, or a calculator. Calculate the TE, then restart the video. I'll provide the correct answer and how I got it. Here are our values for Z-score, CV percent, and bias percent. Remember that our formula is down in the corner. Go ahead and pause the video now. The TE is 10.1%. Here's how I got that figure. First, I substituted the values into the formula. Then I multiplied 1.65 by 3.2. Then I added 5.28 and 4.8. Finally, we have a total error of 10.1%. Now that we've determined the TE for the test, how do we conclude if it's an acceptable amount of error? This is done by comparing the TE to the assigned quality specification for the test in the form of the total allowable error limit. I encourage you to take a look at our video for TEA for additional information. The TE of the test should not exceed the TEA. If it does, action should be taken to correct or improve the testing system. Noting the actual values for imprecision and bias can help identify where reasoned troubleshooting can begin. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. For all of your QC needs, visit www.qcnet.com.